Hello students, so I am taking up the session for class 10th and the chapter is linear equations in two variables. So to solve a system of equations, in total we have four methods. One is the graphical method already explained, and that there are three algebraic methods: the substitution method, elimination method and the cross multiplication method. So today we are doing the cross multiplication method. Let us first take the standard form of linear equations in two variables. So in standard form, linear equations will be written like this, where c1 and c2 are constants, x and y are the variables, and even a2, b1, b2 are also constants and coefficients of x and y. So for cross multiplication method, first thing is that we have to write the equations in standard form like this. After that, we will write them in a certain pattern. We will take these two coefficients, then c1, c2, a1, a2, and at the end again b1, b2. First we will write x here, then y, then 1 for constant, then b1 b2 c1 c2 a1 a2 and again b1 b2. Then we have to draw arrows, forward pointing arrows, from here to here and here to here, which makes a cross multiplication kind of sign. That's why this method is called the cross multiplication method. After this, I have to take x upon, I have to take product using these arrows, b1 c2 minus b2 c1. So this subtraction I am doing, the first arrow I will follow and this will be multiplied with this minus this multiplied with this. Similarly, I will do for y, it will be c1 a2 minus c2 a1 and then equal to 1 upon a1 b2 minus b1 a2. So like this I have to write. And then I can solve this part and this part together, because this will have only constants, and get the value of x, and to get the value of y, these two will be solved. So let us take one example. So the given system of equations to us is 2x plus 3y equal to 17 and 3x minus 2y equal to 6. So first we have to bring this to the standard form. That means bringing the constant to the other side. The equations will become 2x plus 3y minus 17 equal to 0 and 3x minus 2y minus 6 equal to 0. That means here the a1 is this, a2 is 3. So we will just write it, the values of a1, a2, b1, b2 and c1, c2. A1 is 2, A2 is 3, B1 is 3 and B2 is minus 2, C1 is minus 17 and C2 is minus 6. Thus we have written all the coefficients so that when we form it, it will be easier for us. So now what we had here was B1, B2, X, B1, B2, then C1, C2, then A1, A2. And then again b1 b2 like this. So by copying the values, after drawing this pattern, I will copy down the values from here. b1 b2 means 3 and minus 2, and then I have c1 c2 means minus 17 and minus 6. After that I have a1 a2, so that will be 2 and 3. And then again at the end I have b1 b2. So that will be 3 and minus 2. So this I have to take below x, this below y and this below 1. So let me take it below x. It will be 3 into minus 6. So minus 18. Minus 2 into minus 17 plus 34. So like this. then equal to y upon minus 17 into 3 will be minus 51 minus minus 6 into 2 will be minus 12. So minus minus 12 will become plus 12 later. Then here it is 1 upon 2 into 2 minus 4 minus 3, 3 is 9. So now let's solve it a little more. So here I will get x upon minus 18 minus 34, so minus 52. They are added and the sign of the greater number is taken as minus. And this will be equal to, this is minus 51 plus 12. And this will be 1 upon minus 13. So, finally, after simplifying, I am getting x upon minus 52, y upon minus 39 is equal to 1 upon minus 13. Now, I will take this and this. X upon minus 52 equal to 1 upon minus 13. Thus, it gives me x is equal to minus 52 upon minus 13. So, x equal to 4. Negatives get cancelled. So, x comes out to be 4. Now, for finding out y, I will take this and this. So, y upon minus 39 is equal to 1 upon minus 13. That means y equal to minus 39 upon minus 13. Again, the negatives get cancelled. So, this comes out to be 3. Thus, I get the values x is equal to 4 and y is equal to 3. So, this is the solution. So, now you can solve questions based on the cross multiplication method. This is the solution. Thank you.